please stand with us?
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more in night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like a blind man, I wandered along. Worries and fears I claimed for my own. Then like the blind man, God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more in night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I was a fool to wander astray. Straight is the gate and narrow the way. Now I have traded the wrong for the right. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more in night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Some glad morning, some glad morning. When this life is o'er, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Just a few more weary days.
Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new soul, oh my soul.
Seated.
All right, good morning, church.
Good morning.
Welcome to Dassel Covenant Church. We're so happy you're able to join us here this morning. I'm Adriana Forsman. I'm covering for Pastor Darren. He is still with family celebrating the Christmas season up in International Falls. So if you are new with us this morning, we have a Connect card ahead in front of you in the pew. If you could just fill that out and put that in the offering plate when it goes by, we would love to connect with you further. Also, there are prayer cards right in front of you, and there will be a time of praise and prayer where we will have microphones available for you to share your requests out loud. But if that's intimidating to you, then please feel free to write them down and put those also in the offering plate when it comes by. So we have some family life and announcements for you guys. I'm going to just highlight a couple. You can read the rest that apply to you. So the students are halfway through their Christmas break, meaning we didn't have Sunday school this morning, but we will start again next week, and also meaning we have no activities on Wednesday. That is New Year's Day, actually. So no youth group, no Awana. Enjoy your Christmas break. Speaking of youth stuff, there's an announcement that's not in the bulletin, but it is up on the screens, and it is January 3rd. There's a senior high Nerf War night from 7 to 9 p.m. So we have extra guns. If you have a gun, feel free to bring your own, and we will supply all the bullets. And there is no children's church today. Both our children's church ladies are out, so no children's church. And that's all I had to say. Sweet. So that brings us to our worship focus for this morning, which comes from Colossians chapter 1, verse 16, which says, "For in him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities, all things have been created through him and for him." And so this morning we're going to be looking at the person Jesus, who is awesome, and we'll be talking about him and his supremacy and awesomeness. So with that, you can stand and join us. Yes, stand and join us in hymn number 195.
Our hearts on fire, glory
seated. I'll have my ushers hold off back there for a second. I'm gonna tell a little story, and I don't want to be up here. So for the worship of giving this morning, if you are new with us, please don't feel obligated to give. We want you to just come and simply receive from us this morning. You are not under obligation to put anything into the offertory. But I have a story instead of actually reading from Luke 6, and it's about this little girl. Her name is Haiti Mae Wyatt, and this is a true story. This is told from the pastor himself in this story. One Sunday morning, the pastor of a church went outside to find a group of children who were unable to get in to go to Sunday school because the building was too crowded. One of those children was 6-year-old Hattie. When the pastor saw her, he lifted her up onto his shoulders, carried her inside, and found a place for her to sit in the Sunday school class. The next morning, as he walked to church, the pastor saw Hattie again and stopped to talk to her. He told her that he hoped someday the church would be able to build a building that was large enough so that there would be room for all the children who wanted to attend. Around 2 years later, little Hattie died, and the pastor was asked to preach at the funeral service. After the service, Hattie's mother handed the pastor a small purse containing 57 cents. She told him that Hattie had been saving her pennies to help the church build a new Sunday school building. The pastor took the 57 cents back to his church and told the people about the little girl who had been saving her pennies to help build the new building. The people were so inspired by Hattie's gift that they gave faithfully until they built a wonderful new building with plenty of room for all the children who wanted to attend. I'm sure that Jesus would say, Hattie gave more than anyone to build that great church. She gave all that she had. I'll invite the ushers forward now while I pray. Dear Heavenly Father, every gift that we have is from you. Everything we have is from you. And so help us to remember that we should give back to you with a cheerful heart. And it's in your name that I pray. Amen.
We never lose our one. Now is our time for our prayer and praise. We have some mics here. If anybody has some praises or a prayer request, please make them known. Otherwise, we'll continue. Tracy?
I have a prayer request. I have a dear friend and co-worker. Her name is Nina, and her husband have been trying to have children for many years. She's in her mid-40s now, and they are unable to, but they are going through the process of adoption. And they have a little girl, but the birth parents have the ability to reverse that decision. And she's kind of in that waiting period right now. And so my prayer is that if it be God's will, that they are able to adopt this little girl. But if not, that this would be something that would strengthen their faith either way and draw them closer to God. So if you would please keep Nina in your prayers.
Thank you, Tracy.
You need a mic?
Marcella.
Huh? I would like the church to join us in praying for Jeannie. Jeannie does not know God, but she is asking questions. Would you join us in asking the Holy Spirit that if it is His will, that He would soften her heart and that He would give us words of wisdom for her?
Anyone else? Thank you. Let's go to prayer. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we come to you. We thank you for the privilege we have to gather together as a body of Christ. Father, we want to lift up our prayer concerns to you. On our list of united in prayer, we have Barb and Steve Swanson in Sweden, our leadership team of women's ministry, Amanda and Heidi, our church ministry of confirmation. In our senior care, we have Esther and Gladys and Alita, Norman, and we pray especially today for Corinne, as she is pretty close to going home to come and see you face to face, Lord. Dr. Jim this morning, and he said that today might be the day. I pray for her. We pray for her peaceful passing and that she would get a reward. And also, Jim made known that today would be 5 years ago today that his dad, Bob, passed away also. And Lord, in Lakeside, we have Gladys and Pauline, Clarice and Dean and Phyllis and Velma. Harriet, Armed Services, we want to pray for Dustin Paulson as he serves in the military and all of our military around the world, that you'd bless and protect them. College students of Anna Peterson, we have her today, and our college students out going to further their education. Be with them and protect them, we pray. In special ongoing prayer, we have Steve Dill, Dan Olson, and Corey Davis. Also, for our prayer request this week, Mary Lukema has passed and is with you, Lord. And we have a funeral service coming up. The visitation will be Tuesday this week at 10 a.m. Funeral will be 11. Also, we want to pray for Tracy's friend, Nina, and her husband as they go through the adoption process, that things would go well, that your will would be that will be done. And we pray that they will get this child that they are hoping and praying for, and give them the peace that passes all understanding as they go through this process, Lord. And also Jeannie, Marcella's friend, that she that your Holy Spirit would soften her heart, that she'd come to know you as Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, as we pray that many of our loved ones and families and friends and acquaintances and co-workers also, that they would come to know you. Lord, we pray that you'd be with everyone as they travel. This weather is pretty sketchy and pretty dangerous. We pray that you'd help people to travel safely, watch over them, give them extra protection, we pray. Lord, we'd be with Pastor Darren and Brenda and their family as they are on a well-deserved vacation. Be with them, keep them safe also, Lord. Father, we pray that you'd help us all here in our needs and wants and wishes. We know everyone has needs, wants, and wishes, and prayer concerns, and we're not all necessarily willing to speak them out loud, but we know you know, and we pray that you would hear our hearts, our thoughts, our prayers. Lead us, guide us, direct us, touch us, and heal us, we pray in Jesus' name, Father. And as we pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Today we have Lily reading the scripture.
Scripture is John 1, verses 1 through 14. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life. Life was the light. The light that shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God, and his name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning the light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives the light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and through the world was made through him. The world did not recognize him. He came that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or of a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Awesome. Thank you, Lily. All right. So I don't know if any of you can relate to this idea, but I had a roommate in college, we lived in Chicago, who kind of stuck to herself, stuck around campus, didn't really go out exploring much, and then she had friends come and visit her. And after her friends had visited her for a weekend, she said, man, it was so nice to have visitors come and show me my own stuff. And it's just kind of a thing that happened. You get used to your surroundings. You get comfortable where you are, forget how cool it is, how awesome it is. I think another great example of this happens with anybody living near an ocean. The picture to your left is my friend, one of them, is Allie. She is currently living in Portugal. She's been there for a couple years, and I called her, and, oh, well, what's your plans for the rest of the day? Well, I'm going to go grocery